to the Zwift Crit Club. Stage 1, Volcano Circuit. We raced this 2 hours ago. And I couldn't have bungled the finish any worse than I did. Something about that uphill finish has got me confused. But, popped my arrow way too early, led the pack out. I messed it up badly enough, and the race is short enough that I don't want to take another shot at it. So we're going to do that. We got the Alienware kit, orange headband in game, orange headband out of game. Make myself easy to spot. 50 plus riders, which is actually better attended than the race 2 hours ago, so that's good. Let's see if I can not screw it up as badly. I will put chapter markers in and note any attacks. Probably it's all about lap 3, so. But feel free to skip ahead. I'll get it again, hopefully. Just trying not to spend any physical resources. Good Lord. Look at me go. I did not shut it down. It just doesn't matter. Sorry, get the mistakes out at the beginning of the race, or it doesn't matter. As long as I get the end right. Or at least better. I'd like it to be because of physical limitations, not mental ones, that I win or lose. guess I should probably recognize the pink and blue jersey. I don't, but it looks like a pretty big team. It's home. This is the section I keep messing up. I don't necessarily expect to win this. I just want to learn how to do an uphill finish. Just get the experience, I should say. Until I learn. Maybe the way is take the legs out of the 1 minute power guys. I don't know. I'm just trying to loiter around the front. Respond to the moves that make sense to respond to. And not to burn too many matches in the process. I may just hold on to that one. We'll see what lap two brings though. All this pink and blue at the front does make me nervous, but nervous isn't any good. So, ride your race. seems to be a consistent push right here. Every lap. Depending on how much pressure they put on here, I'll either keep the arrow or use it.
Yeah, may have let him out again, but I feel better about that. I know there are at least three people, more than that, that have better B category sprint than I do. I'll watch the replay, but at least that time, I feel like maybe a tad early, but last time I was like 200 meters early. This time I think people just have better sprint than I do. And I don't know how to. You gotta hope somebody else takes it out of them. If I try to take it out of them, I'll have no legs at the end. So I just have to hope somebody else does. And then do the best I can. So short term, may not be an easy fix. Long term, I'm gonna start doing workouts. Well, short term, with long term results, I'm gonna start doing workouts on Glasgow Crit Circuit, hitting that sprint at the end, and Glide Kicker in the middle. Short rest, basically the distance in between the two for rest. Start building that short distance power. It seems so, what's a deciding factor, let's be honest, in most of the races. And as a long distance runner, it's the opposite of how my metabolism is geared. So, currently, so we're making changes on the fly. Body will adapt. All right, I will link probably the failed end of the last race for a comparison of what completely not to do. And I think it's safe to say I improved, but I still have room for improvement at the same time. All right, we'll split video, come back to power, and a brief hit of that failed race 2 hours before this. See you then.
Yeah, so this is the 10 a.m. race, and I don't know what I was thinking. I was thinking for some reason aero wouldn't be that much value on the uphill. I would use it to save some energy, just getting to the front and then pushing. But also, in my head it was going to last a little longer, so by the time I got it in my sprint, the aero was wearing off. I definitely completely bungled that. And then everybody that times aero right comes zipping past me. So I finished sixth, in the second race I finished fourth, but in the second race I finished fourth, I think, executing well and just getting beat. But there you go. How not to do it.